This is Dr. V. Anita Rani, Associate Professor of Chemistry from Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Corrosion control methods we are discussing. In the last previous class, we discussed about cathodic protection, sacrificial anodic protection method, impressed current cathodic protection method. Today we are going to discuss about electroplating, electroless plating, and cementation process. So electroplating, the process of depositing the coating metal on the surface of the base metal or non-metal by electrolysis is called electroplating. The process of depositing the coating metal on the surface of the base metal by electrolysis is called electroplating. So the base metal that is anodic to the coating metal. So the base metal should be anodic to the coating metal. This base metal should be anode, coating metal will be cathode. And the electrolyte is the solution containing the metal ions to be deposited on the base metal. And the electrolyte will be that what we are taking the soluble, the electrolyte is the solution containing the metal ions to be deposited on the base metal. That will be deposited on the base metal. The base metal is made cathode and the coating metal is anode. The base metal is made cathode and coating metal is anode, or an inert material of good electrical conductivity is also used as an anode. A direct current is passed through the electrolytic solution. Electrolytic solution. We will pass the direct current that is passed through the electrolytic solution. So we can see here, we can understand in a procedure. So here we are taking one beaker. We are taking one beaker. In the beaker, we are taking copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate solution. And we are taking some metallic structure. Some metallic structure we are taking. For example, iron you are taking. You want to give some coating, copper. You are taking anode copper and copper sulfate solution we are taking, and we are connecting here we are connecting that is anode, that is copper metal, that we are connecting the positive pole of the battery, and iron, that is base metal, that is base metal, that we are connecting to the negative pole of the battery, and we are passing a direct current. So when we are passing a direct current, then by passing direct current, what happens here means the decomposition of copper sulfate solution takes place. The decomposition means the chemical reaction takes place here. What means the decomposition of copper sulfate into cations and anions. So Cu2 plus ions and SO4 2 minus, cations and anions. So this Cu2 plus ions, so this will move towards the cathode. So this is what? This is cations. So cations, positively charged ions, that will move towards the, Now iron metal, base metal, it behaves as a cathode. It will move towards the cathode. And anions, that is sulfate ions, it will move towards the positively charged electrode, that is anode, that is copper. So by movement of these positive ions and the negative ions, that is Cu2 plus ions, moving towards the cathode, and reduction takes place at base metal, that is Cu2 plus ions. It will take electrons from the cathode and it will be reduced to copper atoms. So these are copper atoms. That yellow layer is copper atoms. So that is layer is formed on the surface of the base metal. Now iron is protected. By this protective layer copper. So this is called electroplating. Means the depositing of the coating metal on the surface of the base metal by electrolysis is called electroplating. Electrolysis is nothing but we know about electrolytic cell. We will take in a beaker electrolyte, for example copper sulfate solution. We will take anode and cathode. When we are passing a direct current, that decomposition of copper sulfate takes place into ions, cations and anions. So these cations move towards the cathode, anions will move towards the anode. So this is about electrolysis process. So that process only takes place here in electroplating. So we understood now the procedure here, what is happening, what is the reaction taking place by passing a direct current at anode and cathode. So at anode oxidation takes place, at cathode reduction takes place. Oxidation means loss of electrons and reduction means gain of electrons. So in the procedure of electroplating, what we are going to take base metal, that article, it will be first it is treated with organic solvent, tetrachloroethylene. It will treated with the organic solvent tetrachloroethylene to remove any oil is there, any grease particles are there, any oil is there, that is removed by tetrachloroethylene. So for example, we are taking 1 cup, we want to go for electroplating. First we have to remove any impurities, any oil particles by taking an organic solvent tetrachloroethylene. Then it is treated with dilute HCl or H2SO4 to remove any oxides, any scales, any layers formed that can be removed by treating with the dilute HCl or H2SO4. So for nickel and copper, HCl is used. For chromium plating, sulfuric acid is used. The cleaned article, after cleaning the article, that is made cathode of the electrolytic cell. Means, so here when we are connecting two electrodes, anode and cathode, so the cathode will be base metal. The cleaned article will be cathode of an electrolytic cell. What is a cell? When we take two electrodes, when we are dipping in electrolyte and connecting to the circuit, that is called a cell. So now the anode is either the coating metal itself or inert material of good electrical conductivity like graphite. So this anode, you can take a coating metal or you can take graphite. Inert material of good electrical conductivity, we can take graphite also. So this is like a construction of electrolytic cell for electroplating. So the electrolyte is the solution of soluble salt of the coating metal. What we want to give the coating on the surface of the metal, that coating metal, so that we will take electrolyte, that is the solution of soluble salt of the coating metal, we will take as electrolyte. So when direct current is passed, coating metal ions migrate to the cathode and get deposited there. Thus thin layer of coating metal is obtained on the article made as cathode. So for brighter and smooth deposit, and we'll take low temperature conditions, medium current density and low metal ion concentration are used. So the article that we cleaned with the trichloroethylene, then we have treated with dilute SCl or dilute S2S4 vapor to remove oxides. Then that cleaned article we have constructed as electrolytic cell. That is cleaned article made cathode of the electrolytic cell and anode made of pure coating metal. Then electrolyte that is dipped in the salt solution of the coating metal, which act as electrolyte. So when direct current is passed, the coating metal ions migrate to the cathode and deposited on the base metal. And that base metal article, so that deposited coating metal, it is in the form of a thin layer. So we know the process now. What is the electroplating? That is, coating metal is deposited on the base metal by passing direct current through an electrolytic solution containing the soluble salt of the coating metal. And the theory of electroplating we understood now. Anode is made of coating metal, and during electrolysis the concentration of electrolytic bath that remain unaltered. Since the metal ions deposited from the bath are replenished continuously by the reaction of the free anions of the electrolyte with the anode metal. So the reactions taking place during electroplating process. So we understood the reactions, copper sulfate, that is decomposing into Cu2 plus ions and sulfate ions. So when we are passing the current, then that will be decomposing or ionizes to Cu2 plus ions and sulfate ions. So that Cu2 plus ions go to the cathode and get deposited there and undergo reduction reaction, where copper atoms will be deposited at cathode. And free sulfate ions migrate to the copper anode and dissolve an equivalent amount of the copper to form copper sulfate. So there it will undergo. So here at anode, the sulfate ions, it move towards the anode and this will be dissolving an equivalent amount of Cu to form copper sulfate will be formed. Means it will undergo copper sulfate forming and losing electrons will be taking place at anode, and that electrons are passed from anode to cathode. So the copper sulfate thus formed dissolves in the electrolyte. Thus there is a continuous replenishment of electrolytic salt during electrolysis. So at cathode reduction takes place, at anode oxidation takes place. So this is about electroplating process. So we can understand, we are giving a copper plating for example. So we will connect that to the battery, and anode we are connecting to the battery, positive pole of the battery, and this key we are connecting to the negative pole of the battery. And when we are passing a direct current, then copper atoms, that copper will be deposited on the surface of iron key. So we can understand now here how electroplating of copper is taking place. So applications, very good applications are there in electroplating. This technique is used in industries to produce metallic coatings, both metals and non-metals electroplated. So metals can be electroplated, non-metals also electroplated. So in metals, electroplating increases the corrosion resistance, means metals does not undergo corrosion and chemical attack does not occur. It can increase hardness and wear resistance, etc. So applications of electroplating, that metals can be protected by electroplating process and we can prevent the corrosion. So non-metals also we can go for electroplating process. That increases the strength and decorates the surface of non-metals, like we can take plastics, wood and glass. So electroplating of gold on plastics also will go for process of electrolysis, and we can go for electroplating. So we can take some examples. You can see gold plated watch, copper plated mug, silver plated teapot and silver plated goblet, and chrome electroplated tap. So all these are electro, that is, we are giving a coating metal, that we are giving a coating metal on the surface of the base metal. So this is about electroplating process. So we have no applications of metals and non-metals also. So electroless plating. Electroplating means we are passing a direct current to the articles, and we are going to giving a coating on the surface of the base metal by passing a current. Electroless plating means without using electricity. Electroplating means by using electricity, we are giving a coating on the surface of the base metal. Coating metal on the surface of the base metal. In electroless plating, without using electrical energy, without using electricity also, we can give the coating metal on the surface of the base metal to prevent corrosion. So electroless plating, it is known as chemical plating. Means we use the chemicals. It is known as chemical plating. Or autocatalytic plating, we use catalyst also. Autocatalytic plating, and it is a class of industrial chemical process. In industries mostly we use electroless plating also, that create a metal coating on various materials by autocatalytic chemical reduction of metal cations in a liquid bath. So by reduction process means nothing, we know what is reduction process, that is metal ions, it will take electrons and reduce to metal. This is reduction. So by reduction process, so the metal ions will gain the electrons and reduce to the metal. So by autocatalytic chemical reduction of metal ions, chemical reduction of metal ions in a liquid bath, so that metal ions will be deposited on the base metal. It will be deposited on the base metal. So that is about electroless plating without using electrical energy or electricity. So in this technique of depositing a noble metal, that is more active metal, from its salt solution on a catalytically active surface of less noble metal. So we will take a noble metal, for example we are taking a copper metal, that is less active metal, noble metal, from its salt solution on catalytically active surface, some catalyst we use on catalytically active surface of less noble metal, that is iron metal, less noble metal, that is more active metal. So by employing a suitable reducing agent without using electrical energy. So we have to use a suitable reducing agent without using electrical energy. So that by this reduction process, that metal ions that can be deposited on the base metal. So reducing agent here, when we use reducing agent, for example, sodium, you are taking reducing agent. So it will undergo oxidation easily, means it is strong reducing agent. So it will undergo oxidation easily. So that electrons are taken by the metal ions. And reduced to the metal and deposited on the base metal. So the added reducing agent causes the reduction of metal ions to metal, means reduction takes place, causes the reduction of metal ions to metal, which gets plated over the catalytically activated surface, giving a highly uniform but thin coating. So a thin coating we will get on the surface of the base metal, thin coating. So metal ions, for example, you are taking copper, Cu2+ ions, plus you are adding some reducing agent, So that will undergo oxidation, and that electrons are taken by metal ions and reduced to the metal. That metal is deposited. That metal is deposited like a thin layer. Okay, thin layer. Like this is iron base metal. A thin layer will be copper. So it is the autocatalytic redox reaction on pre-treated catalytic surface. On pre-treated catalytic surface. So electroless plating means. So here we are taking a chemical plating, autocatalytic plating. So we will take the reducing agent plus we are taking the metal ions, and that metal ions, it will undergo reduction, and that will be reduced to the metal. That metal will be it will form like a thin coating on the surface of the base metal. So this is about electroless plating, that is without using electricity, reduction process will be taking place and depositing of the coating metal on the surface of the base metal. Preparation of active surface of the object to be plated. So first we have to prepare the active surface of the object. So if you are taking printed circuit board or anything, you have to make into active surface of the object. So before going to the electroless plating, so first you have to go for etching process, that is acid treatment, that is removal of impurities, nothing but you have to take dilute SDSO4 or dilute HCl. You have to dip the article in that, then any impurities are there we can remove from the article. So then we have to treat with the stannous chloride, or following by dipping with the palladium chloride. We can dip with the palladium, we can dip with the palladium chloride, stannous chloride, palladium chloride, palladium chloride or stannous chloride. So this treatment yields a thin layer of palladium on the treated surface, like active surface we will get on the surface of the base metal. So example, mainly we go this treatment we will do for plastics and printed circuit boards. Plastics and printed circuit boards. So you have to first remove the impurities by acid treatment. Then you have to dip in stannous chloride or palladium chloride. Then you will get a layer of palladium on the treated surface. Plating bath is composed of. So we completed active surface of the article. Now preparation of active surface of the article. Next we have to go for plating bath. We have to prepare a plating bath. What we have to take for plating bath? You have to take soluble salt of the metal. Soluble salt of the metal. Soluble salt of metal. For example, you are taking copper sulfate. Soluble salt of the metal you have to take. Then reducing agent. You have to add reducing agent. You have to add reducing agent. You have to add reducing agent, reducing agent. We are taking formaldehyde, reducing agent, hypophosphate also we can take, sodium hypophosphate. Complexing agent like tartrate, citrate, EDTA, succinate, etc. This improves the quality of deposit. So in that after adding reducing agent, we can add, for example, succinate. We can add succinate. To improve the quality of deposit, to get a good quality of deposit, we have to add succinate or tartrate or citrate EDTA. Exaltant like succinate, fluoride, glycinate, etc. This enhances the plating rate. So to get a, to increase the plating rate, then we have to go for we have to use the exaltants like a fluoride or glycinate. We have to add in the plating bath. For example, we are adding fluoride to increase the plating rate. Then stabilizers like thiourea, cation sulfate, calcium, etc. is added to prevent the decomposition of plating bath solution. So stabilizers we have to use cation sulfate, calcium, that is added to prevent the decomposition of plating bath. To prevent the decomposition of plating bath solution, we have to add some stabilizers. To improve the stability of the plating bath solution, we have to add cation sulfate or calcium or thiourea. Buffer like a sodium acetate, we have to add to control the pH of the bath. To control the pH of the bath, we have to add sodium acetate. So after adding fluoride, for example, we have taken, then you can add, for example, you can take thiourea, then you can add sodium acetate. So this is a plating bath. So we prepared now. We have taken one beaker, we have added soluble salt of the metal, then we have added reducing agent formaldehyde, then we have added complexing agent to improve the quality of deposit, then we have added exhaltant to increase the plating rate, then we have added stabilizers to prevent decomposition of plating bath solution. Then we have added buffer to control the pH of the bath. So electrolysis plating, we know now how it can be taken. Okay, it is a chemical plating or autocatalytic plating. So in this diagram you can understand here how electrolysis plating, that is copper plating, taken place, electrolysis plating or electrolysis plating of copper. So the insulators like plastics, printed circuit boards and glass that are used as a base objected and treated by stannous chloride or palladium chloride, and it is electroplated through a hole technique. So the bath solution is made of copper sulfate, formaldehyde and sodium hydroxide and Rochelle salt and EDTA, complexing and exhaltant. It is used as complexing and exhaltant, and pH of the bath solution it should be 11, pH 11. We maintain the plating bath solution pH, and the temperature we maintain room temperature 25 degree centigrade. And what is the reaction taking place here when we are plating bath solution, then we will dip the base metal. So when we are dipping the base metal, then what are the reactions taking place? Now this is the base metal. Now what are the reactions taking place? So the Cu2+ ions, so that will undergo reduction. The copper Cu2+ ions, it will take electrons, undergo reduction and reduce to copper atoms. So that will be deposited on the surface of the base metal. That will be deposited on the surface of the base metal. So here when we are taking a formaldehyde, formaldehyde 2HCHO+4OH-, so that will undergo oxidation reaction. 2HCHO+2H2O+H2+2 electrons, that will undergo oxidation. Formaldehyde, that will, in presence of hydroxide ions, it will undergo oxidation reaction, means losing electrons. That electrons are taken by the copper and reduced to copper atoms. That copper atoms are deposited on the base metal. So overall reaction will be Cu2+2HCHO+4OH-, so that is reduced to copper atoms, +2HCHO-+H2. So this is the reaction taking place in the plating bath solution after dipping the base metal. So now reducing agent, it will undergo oxidation process, and what we are taking, soluble salt of the metal Cu2+ ions, so that will undergo reduction process. By this redox reaction, where here the plating, that is electrolysis plating, is taking place without using electrical energy, the electrolysis plating coating metal is deposited on the surface of the base metal. So advantages. So electroless plating we understood now. Here we are taking in plating bath solution soluble salt of the metal, noble metal. Then we are taking a reducing agent, that is less noble metal. Then redox reaction takes place, that is oxidation reduction reaction. Then that copper atoms, it will be deposited on the surface of the base metal. So what are the advantages of electroless plating means? Here no electrical energy is required. No electrical energy is required. Plating on articles made of insulators like plastics and semiconductors can be easily carried out. So for plastics we go for electroless plating. Even intricate parts means irregular shapes can be plated uniformly by electroless plating. So applications will be electroless plating of copper, that is used for making printed circuit boards. Printed circuit boards we can go for electroless plating. Electroless plating. This is about the method of electroless plating. Now we completed electroplating. Electroplating means that is by supplying direct current, we can give the depositing of the coating metal on the surface of the base metal. Electroless plating means by reduction process, that is by redox reaction, reduction process, that is coating metal can be plated and that is deposited on the surface of the base metal without using electrical energy. Now cementation process, this is also one method of method to protect the metals without undergoing corrosion. So cementation, or it is also called diffusion coatings. So this type of coatings are obtained by heating the base metal in a revolving drum containing the powdered coating metal. See, for example, you are taking, like, this is one container, one drum. This is a drum. So in this drum, you are taking like a drum. This is a drum. So in this drum, you are taking powder coating metal. This is a powder coating metal. And you have to take base metal. So this is cementation process. So now this type of coatings are obtained by heating the base metal in a revolving drum. We have to rotate the drum. Revolving drum containing powdered coating metal. So you have to take in powder form coating metal. For example, zinc powder you have to take. Powdered coating metal. So diffusion of the coating metal into the base metal takes place, resulting in the formation of the layers of alloy varying composition. So it is like a layer it is formed coating metal on the surface of the base metal by diffusing that powdered coating metal on the surface of the base metal. It is forming like a layer on the surface of the coating metal, on the surface of the base metal. So there are three processes there in cementation: sheridizing, colorizing, chromizing. Sheridizing, this scientist Sherrard Cowper Coles in 1890, he only invented the process, sheridizing process, process of the cementation using zinc powder as coating metal on the surface of iron. So he used zinc powder as a coating material on the surface of iron. So sheridizing means that is using zinc powder as a coating material on the surface of the iron. So iron article, we are selecting that iron article to be coated. First it is cleaned by acid pickling process. Acid pickling means we use dilute H2SO4 and we remove the impurities what is present in the article, on the surface of the article. So acid pickling process, and rotated for 2 to 3 hours in a drum. containing zinc dust at 350 to 370 degree centigrade. So we have to maintain the temperature 350 to 370 degree centigrade, and we have to give the coating, zinc coating, on the surface of the base metal iron by maintaining the temperature 350 to 370 degree centigrade for about 2 to 3 hours. During this process, zinc diffuses into the iron. Zinc diffuses into the iron, forming a iron zinc alloy. Iron zinc alloy at the junction of the base metal means it is forming like a layer on the surface of the base metal and coating metal. And thin layer of zinc is deposited on the surface of the iron. So very simple process. We have to take the drum, in that we have to take a powdered coating metal, then we have to take the base metal, then we have to maintain the temperature like 350 to 370 degree centigrade for 2 to 3 hours. We have to do the process, then coating metal that will be diffuses into the base metal and it forms like a layer on the surface of the base metal. So this is about cheradizing process. So in this diagram also we can understand. So here you can see the drum, and you can see the drum here, and you can see zinc powder in the drum, and articles, iron articles, and here it will be rotated for 2 to 3 hours by maintaining the temperature 350 to 370 degrees centigrade for 2 to 3 hours, and zinc will be coated on the surface of the iron articles. Now applications, cheradizing is used for coating small articles like bolts, screws and nuts. So bolts, screws, nuts, you can see in the example. So bolts, screws, nuts, we go for a cheradizing process. So that is the application of cheradizing. So advantages, the metal coating is uniform, we get a uniform coating, and there is no change in the dimension of the articles. Now the second process in cementation is colorizing. So colorizing is the method of coating aluminium on the surface of iron. We are giving on the surface of iron, for example, this is the base metal. So this base metal, on the base metal iron, we are giving a coating aluminium. We are giving a coating aluminium on the surface of the iron by cementation process. The article is cleaned first by sandblasting, means to remove impurities. We go for sandblasting. We use fine sand. We remove the any impurities are there. Any oxide formation, any like a scale formation on the surface of the articles, that is cleaned. That article is cleaned by sandblasting, and heated in a drum, tightly packed drum with a mixture of aluminium powder and aluminium oxide. So we use aluminium powder and aluminium oxide and together, and with adding some aluminium chloride as a flux in reducing atmosphere of hydrogen. So we use aluminium powder, aluminium oxide and some aluminium chloride, and we take that in the drum, and we take the articles, iron articles, and we go for cementation process. So here also we maintain the temperature around 500 degree centigrade, and we go for around 3 hours, and after completing the process, then we get the formation of depositing or diffusing the coating metal on the surface of the iron metal and forming like a thin layer, diffusing of coating metal, that we are taking aluminium metal on the surface of the base metal iron, forming like a layer on the surface of the iron. So this is about colorizing process. So applications will be, so this colorizing is used for the protection of furnace parts. So you can see here furnace. So this furnace parts to give the coating. For example, this furnace is made up of steel or iron. So this is given, for example, iron. It is made up of iron. This is given aluminium coating. So this is given, we are going for colorizing process, cementation process. So this furnace parts, we go for a cementation process, that is colorizing process, to prevent from corrosion. Then chromizing. So cheradizing means giving a zinc coating on the surface of iron. Colorizing means giving aluminium coating on the surface of the iron. Then chromizing means, here we take the chromium powder and aluminium powder. So both we will mixture, we will take here in a drum. So the base metal heated with a mixture of 55% chromium and 45% aluminium, and we maintain the temperature 1300 to 1400 degree centigrade for 3 to 4 hours. We will do the process, and we get the chromium coating, that is a thin layer of chromium that is formed on the surface of the base metal by chromizing process. Applications will be, chromizing is used for the protection of turbine blade. So you can see turbine blade. So these turbine blades we go for chromizing to prevent from corrosion turbine blades. So we go for cementation process, that is giving chromium coating on the surface of the base metal, on the surface of the base metal. For example, here turbine blade that is made up of iron. So by protecting the that base metal, we give the coating chromium on the surface of the base metal. So this is about cementation process. So cementation process, sheridizing, colorizing, chromizing. Sheridizing means we are giving a zinc coating on the surface of the iron base metal. Then colorizing means we are giving aluminium coating on the surface of the base metal, that is iron metal. Chromizing means we are giving chromium coating on the surface of the base metal, iron. So this is about cementation process. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.